Hi guys, how are you today? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a few more pages in my Pass Along journal. This is by Helen Cole. If you're unfamiliar with this journal or you'd like to see my intro video where I discuss a little bit about this journal, go ahead and click up above. I'm going to link the video up there. I'm also going to link it down in the description box. Now, my Pass Along journal is a fantastic journal. I'm just going to tell you briefly about it. If you have no idea, I explain it more in depth in that intro video. So basically, it's about someone. It could be about you or someone else. You fill it out about that person. You pass it to someone else. They fill out a prompt about that person. They pass it to someone else, and so on. So it gets passed around your loved ones, your family, your friends, whoever, and they fill it out about that person. So I picked a few prompts today. If you're unfamiliar with this, and like I said, if you haven't watched the intro video, I'm filling this out about my husband. So let's go ahead, let's dive into the first prompt. I flipped through the book a few times trying to find a prompt that I liked to do today. So the first prompt I found was create a dessert. What dessert would this person be? What would their ingredients be? Do they have a dash of sass with 2 cups of sugar, 3 cups of bravery, and 1 teaspoon of salt? So for mine, I decided to not do one based on my husband's personality like the description said, and I decided to do one based on his favorite things. So I picked a rainbow layer cake, and the reason I picked that is because I wanted to do the colors in the colors of Carly Rae Jepsen's Emotion Sweater from her album, because that's one of my husband's favorite albums. I then sketched a snickerdoodle cookie, which is his favorite cookie, some fruit, the berries from a video game he likes, a mango slice, and figs. He loves mangoes and figs. I also added malt balls at the top and lightsaber pocky sticks because he loves Star Wars. So I just started by drawing this and, of course, outlining it in the Micron fineliner. Then I went in with the alcohol markers and I started coloring everything in. I, of course, started with the layers on the layer cake, coloring it in the same order they are in Carly Rae Jepsen's Sweater. I then went in and started coloring the rest of the toppings as I saw fit. Of course, the lightsabers had to be green and blue, but I could have done one red, I suppose. But then I just went in and I colored everything in and made it look all nice and colorful because, you know, my husband is very outgoing and very sweet, like a cake, and he's very good at making friends really easily and making acquaintances. So I thought this would be really represented in this cake. I wrote to the side what everything meant on the cake so we would remember. And then my sister actually helped me come up with the idea. So I signed her name as well. I glued it in the book. And just like that, once I was done gluing, it took a little minute here, that page was complete. I glued it in a little crooked, so it got kind of wrinkled. But it still looks beautiful, and I'm really, really happy with the outcome. The next prompt I selected was your favorite quote. Ponder a quote that has kept you going or uplifted you. So I didn't really pick the quote I picked, it's not like from a movie or anything. I picked a quote from a song called Anywhere by Evanescence. So I just wrote a little excerpt from it, which is, we're leaving here tonight. There's no need to tell anyone. They only hold us down. And I know that's a little bit of a deep sounding quote. It doesn't necessarily sound uplifting, but it kept me going in a hard time. And a hard time when my husband and I were together, we had a really rough time. And I would think about this song and listen to it. And it would, you know, at the time, it made me know that everything was going to be okay. And that, you know, it made me think about our future together and where we were going to be and how, no matter how tough things get, you know, we would, even though we wanted to, you know, have a different situation, eventually we would. And the song meant a lot to me. So I picked the lyrics and I think he knows that. So I just went in and I outlined it with a brush marker. Then I went in and I colored in this sort of galaxy colored pencil drawing. I wanted to do something a little different. So I went in really lightly and then I started coming in and really layering on that color to make it look nice and galaxy-esque.
Mm-hmm.
after I was done with that, I took out a Posca paint pen. I added some stars to really add to that galaxy theme. I then cut out the window and, of course, glued this page in my book. This one didn't get as crooked as the other one. I love the way it turned out. It may not look super galaxy-y, but it's very abstract, and I kind of love how it looks. So the next prompt I selected isn't really a prompt at all. Helen Cole has included blank pages in the back of the book for you to include additional letters, article clippings, more quotes, drawings, photographs, and so forth of the person. So I actually found those little sticky notes you saw a second ago. Well, not sticky notes, note cards you saw a second ago. They're actually my wedding vows. I found them in a box and I thought, what would be better than to include wedding vows in the back of this book? It's something that means a lot to us. So I decided I was going to include them on one page, and then the other page I was going to do this wedding motif. So I drew some bells with confetti and a banner and a cake. And once I was happy with the drawing, you saw that I flipped it over. I wasn't happy with the first one. So once I was happy with the drawing, I outlined it with my Microm fineliner. I then erased all the pencil marking and I came in with my alcohol markers and I colored everything in. Once I was done with the alcohol marker part, I wanted to do something a little different for this one. So I came in with my colored pencils and I added some shadows and blended it out, and I really wanted these to stand out and look a little more realistic, not so flat. And I know I usually shade with the alcohol markers. I just, like I said, I wanted to try something different and see how this worked. I've seen a lot of other people do it and I've never really done it for myself, and I love the way it turned out. The shading looked really great on these markers. So I just went in, shaded it. Once I was happy with that, I added some highlights. Then I came in and added a little shadow to really give everything depth. Of course, I turned my attention to the other side of the page with the with our vows, and I just took some cardstock, glued in the vows, then I glued it in the book. And that page is complete. I love how it turned out. The wedding page looks a little fun, and it looks more like a birthday than a wedding, but I still love how it turned out. The rainbow confetti is so cute. And then the vows, of course, they're so special to me. I can't believe I found them. Well, that was three more pages in my pass along journal. Which page was your favorite? What do you think of this book? Would you like to see more of this book? Is there another series or book you'd like to see more of? Comment down below. I love hearing from you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you for the next one. Bye!